Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how you can add text anywhere you want in iMovie. MacMost is brought to you by a community of supporters. Join us and get exclusive content at MacMost.com/Patreon. So adding text in iMovie is kind of limited. You have to add a title, and there's a limited number of title styles. You have to use one of those, and you can only adjust it so much. But it's easy to add text anywhere you want in any style you want as long as you import the text as a graphic from an external app. Now you could use a graphics app for that, but we're just going to use Keynote. Alright, so we're going to add some text here in iMovie to this image. And I want it to be in the upper right hand corner and some colors and fonts and things like that. Now using titles here is not going to give me what I want. So instead I'm going to go to Keynote. So in Keynote I'm going to use one of the basic templates here and I'm going to make sure it's a widescreen one so it matches the dimensions of the video. I'm going to get it to zoom out so it fits in. I'm going to get rid of the default stuff here. Now in order for this to work I have to create a transparent image. So I'm going to click on the background here of my empty Keynote slide and I'm going to go to Format on the right. And then I'm going to change the background to no fill. So we'll make it transparent. This step's very important. Now I'm going to add some text. Now if I look back at iMovie here, I want to add some text to the upper right hand corner. I can just eyeball it and kind of put it in Keynote here on this black background. But what I'd like to do is get it precise and work with the colors a bit. So I'm going to do Command Shift 5, which is the macOS Mojave keyboard shortcut for capturing the screen. And I'm going to click on Capture Selected Portion and then I'm going to adjust the area to match the video here. So I'm going to basically get a sample of what it's going to look like. Now instead of using Capture there, I'm just going to do Command C. Command C just copies to the clipboard. So now when I go to Keynote, I can Command V to paste it in and there I've got a sample there. It's pretty small so when I stretch it, it doesn't look very good. It's basically very pixelated. But that's fine. I just want it there for general reference and the colors. Now I'll go and I'll click on the text box here, create some new text, and I'm going to select it and change its style. So I can pick a different font for instance. I can make it much bigger. I'm going to change the color here to something. Position it kind of where I want. I'm even going to go to style and then shadow and add a drop shadow to it. And once I have the text looking like I want, I can now go and export this. So to export it, I want to select the background and delete it. Get rid of that. And now go to File and Export to Images. I want to change from Format to PNG, which will allow me to export transparent images and make sure I have Export with Transparent Backgrounds checked. If you don't have this option, that means you didn't set the background to be no color. So make sure that's done and then go next and then export it. I will export to the desktop. Now I'll hide Keynote and in iMovie I'll move over here and I can see that's that folder that was just created with my image. So there's the image there. I can drag and drop the image into iMovie. I'll go back to iMovie. So now it's notice I dragged and dropped it above the timeline here. So it appears here as basically either cutaway or picture in picture. I'm going to make sure it says cutaway. I'm also going to go to cropping here and I'm going to set cropping to fit. And once I have that set, I can see here it appears on top just like I want. I could even adjust the circles here at the top to have it fade in a bit and fade out.
Now you can use any graphics app capable of producing a transparent image to do this. So if you're more comfortable doing it in Photoshop, for instance, you could do it in Photoshop. I just like how fast you can work with text in Keynote. And you don't have to just stick with text. You can use shapes and all sorts of things. Anything you can add as a graphic element in Keynote, you can include it in your image and then use it as an overlay on top of your video. Now also, you don't have to position things perfectly. You can just create text in Keynote and then position it in iMovie.
So I could just move this to the center here. I can make it a lot bigger for higher resolution. And I can export this the same way, making sure I'm doing PNG transparent. Now when I go to bring this in here, I can add it in the same way. Instead of setting it to cutaway, I can set it to picture in picture. I still want to go and set it to style fit. I'm going to go back to Picture in Picture here. And let me position the playback head right in the middle. I can now drag this around and I could stretch the corners to put it where I want. So in this case, I could move it up here in the top right. I can make it a little bit bigger, maybe play with it a bit in the video. This gives me more versatility later on if I want to make an adjustment. I don't have to go all the way back to Keynote to adjust the size and position of the picture-in-picture text here. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.